So we're going to get started today with how to log into Paycom for the very first time. This is going to be based off of the login information that was sent to you either via email from your HR team or directly through a phone call through your HR team as well. So this information should have already been sent over to you stating how to get into the system, what website to go to, your username, and your temporary password. So we're going to go ahead and show you how to use that. We're going to go to paycom.com up here in the top of your browser. When you get in here, you're going to go ahead and hover over the login button and then click on Employee. Next, we're going to have you enter in the information that is unique to you. Perfect. And it brings us into this area. So the first thing we're going to have you do is note your employee self-service. This is your entire employee self-service, and the first thing we want us to do is basically make sure that this information is unique to you. If you log in and see this is not your name up here in the top left-hand side, please let your team know so that we can get that resolved. You will see then your possibly a position and an email and possibly even a phone number here down below. The next thing we're going to have you do is go over at any time to the Help and Settings menu. We're going to show you some resources available to you. By clicking on this, you can actually see here that by going into the Help menu, it actually shows you a different documentation or manuals on how to navigate the system a little bit in a more detailed fashion. By clicking on any of these, it actually shows you a different manual and step-by-step process on how to do different things within the system. For example, with anything with time off requests, if you have questions on that, go ahead and click on the manuals at any time. And by clicking on one of these, it would actually populate with a manual that actually shows you how to actually go in there and request time off. To give you kind of an example of what it looks like, I'll scroll through this a bit. You can see here that we have some screenshots, how to log into the system, showing you what buttons to select, and so on and so forth. And again, to access that, we went to Help and Settings menu and clicked on Help. So to get back to the home screen anytime, we're going to click on the Paycom icon on the top left-hand side. We're going to go back to here. Also in the Help and Settings menu, you will notice that the change password and address and contact info are two separate fields as well that I always recommend having every employee go in there and verify that your address and contact information is correct. And if you need to change your password to something a little bit more memorable, please do so as well. So once that's taken care of, I'm going to have you actually go ahead and look over here to the notification side. This will be any notifications in the system that might be relating to you. So if your HR team sends you out a document to sign off on, or if your HR team lets you know that there is a to-do list that has your name on it and for you to complete, you'll get a notification not only through your email, but also through your employee self-service, and you would have a red notification number right next to the word notifications. By clicking on this, you would actually have a list of things to do. You can click on that notification itself, and it would bring you where to actually resolve that within the system. Okay, so let's go ahead and show you guys how to navigate the system a little bit. Since you will be going in and adding in documents for invoices into the system in order to get paid off of those, we want to show you on how to actually do this properly. By going into Document and Tasks over here on the left-hand side of your screen, we're going to click on My Documents. Once you get to the screen, you're going to notice a couple things. First, that you can create a new form. You would actually select the form that would apply here. For you guys, it will be Assembly Invoice. If there are any other documentation that you need to upload, your HR team will let you know. But for now, we're going to focus on Assembly Invoice. Next, we're going to choose Add Document. Perfect. So it is now telling us that we need to add in our assembly invoice into the system. Luckily, we already have one created, so we're actually going to go through that and do it this way. If you're using this on your phone, you'll also be able to note that you can actually upload a picture from your phone instead of a chosen file from your computer. So we'll work in the exact same fashion here. Go ahead and choose File. We can go ahead here and select a particular invoice. Select this. We'll choose Add. And once this actually adds into the system, you will then be able to see under your completed documents any particular information that you've uploaded. You'll notice here our latest invoice putting into the system on this line. You'll note here too that the date that it was uploaded will be showing up, the time, here it's in military time, and by who it was done by. Again, this is your username, so that will be unique to you, and that will be able to be accessed by your team on the back end as well. So your HR team will be actually taking your documentation that you'll be uploading it and putting it into the system for you to be able to check on that amount of information. So when you're finished with that, you just want to make sure that that is all ready to go, and your team should get a notification for that. At this point, we can go back into the main menu. And was there anything else you wanted me to cover here today as well, Chris?
You know, for right now, I don't think so. The payroll summaries might be something that we add in a little bit later.
Okay, awesome. So as you guys know, there might be another additional document that you would be adding in later. With the assembly invoice, it sounds like it would be the payroll summary. But for now, that is how you go about that in the system. If you have any additional questions, your team will be able to send you out a manual as well on how this process works, and you can always look back in this video for extra help.